So, I play Flintlock Siege of Dawn, a game that generally went under the radar, mostly because we are in a time right now where people ignore games and hate on them if they aren't massively popular. If they have a main character that is a person of color or a woman, and if it isn't a big budget title, those kind of games get ignored. 60% of gamers don't play new games, so a new game that has a black woman as a main character is a double-A title and is a Souls-like released around the same window as Elden Ring's DLC and Black Myth Wukong. This game was pretty much gonna be dead on arrival. But is Flintlock actually a good game that is unfortunately getting passed over? Well, let's put it on the scales of judgment and see. Flintlock: The Siege of Dawn is an open linear Soul-like game, more Souls-lite than Souls-like. Though it has similarities to many games that follow the Souls formula, it is a game that aims to be slightly more open with its combat and easier. The game, developed by A44 Games, the developers behind the game Ashen, has you play as Nora Vanek, whom, accompanied by a fox god companion named Anki, is tasked with saving mankind by fighting against old gods of the game's universe. Though Nora herself isn't really special in what she does, basic melee attacks and use firearms, Anki has magical powers to combine with an aid Nora, making for a pretty dynamic combat system and traversal system. Before I call Flintlock an open linear game, what I mean by that is the game is open world, but it's more linear than your average open world game. Think of like Star Wars, Jedi Survivor. Like it's an open, location, but you can't just go anywhere and everywhere, at free like you would in like a game like Skyrim or even the new Star Wars game Outlaws. The world of Flintlock is pretty generic for the genre, but does have some cool elements. For example, there are small settlements overrun by undead and some overrun by a royal enemy faction who is backed by the gods. By destroying the mini boss within these settlements, the local community returns to that location, bringing life back into the towns. This is also how you unlock, coffee shop vendor in these main locations that allow you to buy cosmetic items to change up how Nora's appearance is. The story of Flintlock is okay. It's nothing special. It's not something that will have you on the edge of your seats. But the bosses, Anki and the world building will make you interested enough in completing the game. The only downside is the ending is kind of abrupt, so you're pretty much left wondering about a good bit of the game's lore, which for a game like this, a game that I'd say is one of those average games that's okay to just let be average, you the player won't care to read anything in the game when it comes to like is lore books or lore notes to find out more. Whatever the game doesn't explain to you or show you, at face value, you won't care to go further to explore. You won't care to go watch a YouTube video on the lore of the game. Think of something like Elden Ring or Sekiro or any From Software game. The game's universe is so interesting for you, the player, that you decide, I want to know more. I want someone to piece this all together for me, so I'm going to go to YouTube and watch a body video so I can understand the lore. This isn't one of those kind of games. You won't be interested to go to YouTube to go find out about the game's lore. You're going to see what the game has to offer at face value and then move on. The game's interesting enough to play, but not interesting enough to immerse you yourself into the game's universe. Switching gears to talk about the game's combat and traversal, unlike most games in the genre of Soul-likes, Flintlock has more to its movement than just walking from place to place. You can do manual slides, auto slides down angled cliffs, unlimited sprint. There is no stamina bar to limit your movement, which also includes in combat. You can just R1 spam to life's content with no stamina bar. And then there's how black powder is used with movement. You can double jump by throwing black powder on the ground to boost yourself. You also use it to, get across big gaps. You would jump into the air or double jump, and then use your black powder to kind of throw Nor a little further to get across bigger gaps. This is also how you dodge in the game. You have a base dodge, then a black powder dodge where you do a little extra with the help of exploding black powder. Another unique way of traversing in the game is these rift skulls imbued by Anki that allows you to fly across the map to get to secret locations, main locations, and as a shortcut to get back. All that leading to a pretty dynamic or robust mechanic for movement and traveling. Now, as I mentioned before about black powder being used in dodging, a core component of this game's combat is firearms. The game does have Flintlock in its name after all. Firearms come in two classes of usage. You have your quick fire firearms, which you use to interrupt enemy attacks, kind of like the pistol being used for parrying in Bloodborne, or the left arm in Lies of P. Then there is free aim firearms, which you use like a rifle to aim at a given target and shoot. With these, there are multiple firearm types. You have pistols, rifles, mortars, and shotguns. Rifles and mortars are for free aim, and pistols and shotguns are for quick fire. The combat of Flintlock, when everything is in rhythm, is quite nice, but much like a lot of Soul-like games, it can get janky. The game does have parrying, but you can play throughout the entire game without ever parrying or blocking a thing. It's an easier Souls-like even on the hard setting that I played it on. Most of this is because you can just R1 spam and then interrupt with a pistol and then go back to R1 spamming. You know, you get more bullets for your pistol by doing damage. So you get to a rhythm that makes it pretty easy to just, you know, spam a boss to death. Very rarely do you face a boss where you need to do a lot more. And when you do, you know, it's not too hard to use the movement of the game, you know, to have make even the hardest bosses easy. With that, Anki also makes combat a bit easier as well. There is even a skill upgrade where he can distract enemies in situations where you are being, you know, ganked. Now, the final boss, spoiler alert, this is a small spoiler, Anki can get involved in that fight, making it a lot easier. Flintlock is far from perfect game. Outside of the usual jank that tends to exist in all, you know, Soul-like games, there are moments of buggy and glitch situations, as well as moments where the camera is a bit bad, again, something that's very common in these types of games. Flintlock, in my opinion, is an above-average game, a 6 out of 10, if you will. I often see people call it a Game Pass game, which basically just means an average to above-average video game that isn't really special, but it's on Game Pass, so you don't mind giving it a try, which I'd agree with. This is the kind of game that's, you know, great for Game Pass. It's short, it has good moments, and you, the player, don't necessarily lose any money by just giving it a try. If you don't like it, only thing that you lose is your time. If you do, you had another game this year that you enjoyed. I do wish there was more to this game, not just in terms of DLC or sequels, but the game's story ending abruptly and there not really being enough cutscenes or exposition for the story itself, if the story interests you at any level, the interest will not be fulfilled at all and it will just end right there for you. And you won't, again, like I said before, you will not care to go explore YouTube to go figure out what more is there to this game's story. But with all of that said, that is it for this review of Flintlock. Hopefully I provided information of value for you guys. Leave any thoughts you have in the comment section below. I've been your boy, Anubis the Gamer Archer, aka UTX the Archangel, the real undiscovered talent of YouTube. Stay safe, be kind to one another, and I'll see you guys. Mightier. Deuces.